करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेव वशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथ बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु। तदात्मनि निरतेय उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादम् शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं पादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन् ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ इत्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम्। ईक्षतेर्न शब्दम् ईक्षते है इक्षितृत्व श्रवणात् बिकॉज द श्रुति सेज दैट द क्रिएटर ऐक्षत द क्रिएटर सॉ ईक्षितृत्व श्रवणात् बिकॉज द क्रिएटर इज अ सीयर इज अ नोअर देयरफॉर अशब्दम ही तत्प्रधानम् सांख्य परिकल्पितम् दैट प्रधानम् डज नॉट हैव अ प्लेस इन द श्रुति मीनिंग दैट श्रुति डज नॉट मीन प्रधानम् व्हेन द श्रुति यूजेस द प्रोनाउन तत् सो इन फैक्ट दे इंटरप्रेट द वर्ड ब्रह्म आल्सो इज प्रधानम् एंड तत् आल्सो बाय डिफरेंट यू नो डेरिवेशंस एटसेट्रा एंड सो But that is not what is the intention of Shruti because of Ikshanam, because of the effect of Ikshanam seeing. Because Achetanatvat, Pradhanam is Achetanam, unconscious, and seeing cannot be in an unconscious entity. Continuing the arguments. Yesterday we saw how the question was asked, how can Brahman be Brahman that is consciousness or of the nature of knowledge, that knowledge can mean consciousness, knowledge also can mean a cognition or a state of mind. How can Brahman that is of the nature of knowledge, how can it be omniscient? So question was asked, when you say jnanam or consciousness, do you mean jnanam is nityam? Is it eternal or is it impermanent? Anityam. ज्ञान नित्यत्वे ज्ञान विषय स्वातंत्र व्यपदेश न उपपद्यते इति चेत्। इफ ब्रह्मन इज कॉन्शियसनेस दैट इज इटर्नल चेंजलेस देन स्वातंत्र व्यपदेश कर्तृत्व व्यपदेश ब्रह्मन कैन नॉट बी कॉल्ड ए ज्ञान कर्तृ अ नोअर बिकॉज इवन नोअर ऑल्सो इज ए काइंड ऑफ ए कॉस्ट्यूम इज ऑल्सो ए वेशा सो दैट शोज अ चेंज अ नोअर ऑल्सो चेंजेस इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ नॉलेज इफ देर इज ए घटा इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी आई बिकम द नोअर ऑफ घटा और अ पॉट नोअर ऑफ ए क्लॉथ नोअर ऑफ ए ट्री सो नोअर ऑल्सो undergoes a change. If Brahman is eternal consciousness, then it is changeless consciousness. How can kartrutvam, the agency of knowing or knowership, how can it be in consciousness that is eternal? So kartrutva vyapadesha, meaning that the use of this expression kartrut karta, that Brahman is seer. Seer means the one who is the agent of the act of seeing, knower, agent of act of knowing. In case of Brahman, that is eternal consciousness, how can there be the expression or the mention of seer, knower? So, ikshitrutva, when you say Brahman saw, that means that Brahman is seer, Brahman is knower. How can Brahman be called knower or seer when it is changeless consciousness? Itna pratatoshna prakashe visavitari dahati prakashe didi svatantre vyapadesha darshanat. Says, look, like sun, that is pratatam santatam, is constantly shining, constantly burning. So dahati prakashayati, we say that the sun burns, the sun illumines, prakashayati. So how we say about the sun, even though the sun is constantly shining, constantly burning, and still there is vyapadesha, this expression in case of sun that it burns, it illumines. So burns means what? Sun is the agent of the act of burning. Agent is always svatantra, karta is always svatantra, meaning that the sun is independent in the act of burning, act of illumining, svatantra vyapadeshat. Similarly also, even the Brahman is constantly conscious, still there can be vyapadesha, there can be shabda prayoga, there can be expression that Brahman knows. Nanu savituhu dahya prakashya संबंध योगे सति दहति प्रकाशयति इति व्यपदेश स्यात्। लुक, इन केस ऑफ सन यू से दैट द सन बर्न्स व्हेन देयर इज समथिंग बर्निंग, सो व्हेन सन बर्न्स समथिंग, मीनिंग इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सन व्हेन समथिंग बर्न्स, देन विथ रेफरेंस टू व्हाट इज बर्निंग यू से दैट द सन इज बर्निंग, और व्हेन थिंग्स गेट इल्यूमिन, so with reference to objects that are illumined, you say that the sun illumines. So sun gets a designation of a burner or illuminator only with reference to the object that is burned or illumined. Natu brahmanah pragutpatteh jnana karma sanyogah asti. However, in case of Brahman, when Shruti says tat aikshada, Brahman saw. Now that is a state. So sadeva somya idam agrasid, this agre, this is a state or a condition before creation, meaning that nothing is created. Still the Upanishad says Brahman saw. So you can say, yeah, how you see what? When you see, then there must be an object of seeing. When you know, then there is an object of knowing. But there is nothing to see, there is nothing to know before the creation. So in case of sun, it is all right because there are objects that are burning and illumined. So you can call sun one who burns, one who illumines. But there is nothing to illumine or know. How can you say Brahman knows or he knew, it knew at this time of before creation? Na, says no, even that objection also is not valid. Asati api karmani savita prakashate iti kartrutva vyapadesha darshanat. Independently also, asati, even when so avivakshite the asati api avivakshite api. So in fact we independently assign the agency to sun without the reference to object. When we say sun shines, you know, asati api karmani, meaning avivakshite, without vivaksha of karma, without the intention of an object, so without reference to an object also, savita prakashate idi kartrutva vyapadeshat. So prakashayati, when we say it illumines, then there is reference to an object of illumination. But when you say the sun shines, then there is no reference to illumination at all. So without this, without any reference to an object also, we use the expression the sun shines. So when you say sun shines, meaning that sun is the agent of act of shining. So that vyapadesha, that expression is still used without reference to an object. And so also, if there is no object before creation, still we can use that expression of Brahman. Brahman saw, Brahman knew. Evam asati api jnana karmani brahmana tadaikshate iti kartrutva vyapadesha upapatte na vaishamyam. Similarly, asati api jnana karmani, even though before creation there is no jnana karma, meaning what? There is no object of knowledge. Asati api jnana karmani, even though there is no object of seeing, no object of knowledge, but still, just as we say sun shines, so also we can say consciousness illumines, consciousness knows, consciousness sees. Because to know, to see, to shine, to reveal is the nature of consciousness. So now Vaishamyam, that illustration is an apt illustration. Karma apekshayam tu. However, even in the state of dissolution, meaning before creation, there is karma. Even then also, there is an object of knowledge. Suppose we say that karma apekshayam tu brahmani ikshitvatva shruteha sutaram upapannaha. So in case of so karma avivakshayam, kumbhakarasya, how the seeing takes place. So earlier, say Tikakara said, karma avivakshayapi prakash rupe savitari prakashadeti kathanchit prakasha kriyashretvena kartrutva upacharat. So even though there is nothing to, even without reference to what is illumined, we say the sun shines, and that way, in some way, we assign the kartrutvam, the agency to the sun of shining. Tadvat chidatmayapi chidrupena ikshana kartrutva upacharat. Similarly also, for chidatma or Brahman, there is consciousness. Chidrupena, because it is of the nature of consciousness, ikshana kartrutva upacharat. And so because it shines, therefore we can say it sees, or it saw, it knew, upacharika. Not in a primary sense. So either we can say that when Upanishad says that aikshata, it means that it shines, it is conscious, it reveals, it illumines, meaning that to shine is conscious nature of consciousness. So we are talking about an entity that shines even when there is no object to illumine. It is self-shining, self-revealing. Pradhana cannot fall in that category. Sudna Vaishamyam, therefore, the illustration of sun is quite apt for illustrating consciousness. Adhunatu कुंभकारस्य सोपाधि अंतःकरण वृत्ति रूप ईक्षणवत. और यू कैन से दैट कुंभकार लाइक ए पॉट मेकर, इवन दो पॉट्स आर नॉट देयर, स्टिल वी कैन से द पॉट मेकर सॉ द पॉट्स. वी कैन से बिफोर द क्रिएशन द पॉट्स द पॉट मेकर सॉ द पॉट्स. But where are the pots? Before creation, there are no pots and pans. How can the Kumbhakara, how can the Kulala, you know, the pot maker, how can they see? Says, Sopadi Antahkana Vrutta Rupa Ikshanavata. At that time, the pot maker sees those pots in his own mind. Even though there is no object outside to see, still, the pot maker sees those pots and all other vessels in his own mind. How? So, antahkarana vritti rupa. Because the pots are in his mind, even though they may not be outwardly, the pots are in unmanifest state. So, manifest pots are not there, which can be called jnana karma or the object of knowledge, but same pots are there in unmanifest state. In the mind, as a thought in the mind of the pot maker, and that's what the pot maker sees before he creates. Ishvarasyaapi sopadi avidyayaha. Similarly also, in the mind of Ishvara, the total mind, which is called Maya or Samashti Avidya, there also some modification is there. So just as before the creation of parts, some mental modification takes place in the pot maker in the form of the pots that are to be created. Similarly also, in the mind of Ishvara, some modification takes place of the nature of the creation which is to be the universe that is to be created. So, upadi avidyaya vivida srushti samskaraya. So, just as in the pot maker, there are samskaras of pot. Because how can otherwise the pot thought arise in the mind of pot maker when pots are not created? But pot maker knows what the pots are. In the past, he has created pots. And he has pretty much the understanding of the pots that are to be created. Because of his past samskaras, he knows what is to be created. And so also, in avidya or the maya, there are past samskaras of creation. And therefore, there is a knowledge of what is to be created. So that samskara is important. Just as there are pot samskaras in the mind of the pot maker, so also srushti samskara is there in the mind of Ishvara, which avidya mind is. Vivida srushti samskarayaha pralaya avasanena udbuddha samskarayaha. But then you can say that those samskaras of pots and pans are always there in the mind of pot maker. What is new? Something is new because even though the samskaras are there in the pot maker's mind, at the time when he wants to create, then those samskaras are aroused. Then the thoughts of pot arise. Otherwise, he's thinking of something else. So it is not that the pot thought is always there in the mind of the pot maker. The pot thought arises in the mind of pot maker when he is about to create the pot. At that time, the samskaras of the pot, they get aroused in his mind. That's how a pot ghatakar vritti takes place. What ghatakar? Ghata that is yet to be created. Ghata that is yet manifest, that vritti takes place. Similarly also, in Ishvara at that time, when Ishvara is about to create, at that time, the thought of the universe that is to be created takes place at that time. So therefore, pralayava avasanena udbuddha samskarayaha. Because now avasana, the conclusion of the pralaya is there, and now there is going to be the beginning of creation. At that time, those samskaras for the creation, they get aroused, and there is accordingly a modification in the avidya or maya, which is what Brahman sees. Sargonmukaha kaschit parinama sargonmukaha. Sargonmukha means what? Something that is conducive to creation. So just as in a pot maker's mind, takes place, the part thought conducive to the creation of the part. Similarly also, in mind of Ishvara, in Avidya, the modification takes place conducive to the universe that is to be created. Ataha tasyam sukshma rupena nilina sarvakarya vishayakam ikshanam. And therefore, in that vritti, nilina sarvakarya vishayakam, unmanifest. All karya, all the names and forms are unmanifest. Tasya karyatvat karma sadbhavacha. Understand that thought is created. Just as in pot maker's mind, the pot thought gets created when he is about to create the pot. So also in Ishvara's mind, which is samashtya vidya, the universe thought takes place because universe is about to be created. So tasya karyatvat, that transformation, that vritti that takes place in avidya, just as the vritti that takes place in the pot maker's mind is a karya, meaning is something that is created, something that is born in his mind. Similarly also in Ishvara's mind is born the vritti of the thought pertaining to what is to be created. That thought contains the entire universe in an unmanifest form or undifferentiated form. Nilina sarvakarya vishayakam. He sees that vritti in which entire karya, entire universe is nilinam, is unmanifest, is contained potentially. Tasya karyatvat, because that vritti has arisen. It's not always there. It arises when there is creation about to take place. Karma sadbhavacha. Therefore, there is an object of seeing that vritti containing the universe in unmanifest state is the object of seeing, is something that is seen. Therefore, mukhyam kartrutvam. So if you accept the object in this sense, then mukhyam kartrutvam, then Ishvara actually saw. So sutaram upapannaha. Now on the page 106, Ratnavaha says further, nanu mayopadhika. Then we saw further also. So kim punaha tat karma, kim punaha tat karma yat prag utpattehe ishvara jnanasya vishayo bhavati iti. The question is asked. When you say that there is something that Ishvara actually saw at the beginning of creation, what is it? Karma means jnana karma. What is the object of knowledge? Yat pragutpattehe ishvara jnanasya vishayo bhavati iti. That becomes the object of the knowledge of Ishvara. Says tattva anyatva abhyam anirvashaniye naam rupe. The universe that is of the nature of name and form, still the names and forms right now are avyakrita, undifferentiated, unmanifest. And we cannot say that they are separate from Brahman, nor can we say they are not separate from Brahman. So tattva anyatva abhyam anirvashaniye. The creation is mithya. Creation of name and form is mithya. And there are samskaras, those mithya creation, unmanifest names and forms are there. Vyachikirshite is what? Avyakrate sukshmatmana sthite vyakartum sthulikartum ishte. Sukshmatmana sthite. At that time, the names and forms are in a subtle form, unmanifest form. And vyachikirshite, Ishvara wants to bring them to manifestation, makes them tangible. So also before creation they are in intangible state, and Ishvara wants to make them tangible. Just as for a pot maker, the pot is in intangible state. In his mind, he wants to create a tangible pot. See, Ratna Prabha, Nanu, Mayoparika, Bimbachin Matra Sishvasya, Katham Ikshanam Prati, Mukhyam Kartrutvam, Kruti Abhavati Ched. Now the question is asked, Nanu, Mayoparika, Bimbachin Matra Sishvasya. So what is Ikshanam? When we say, Ishvaras Brahman saw. What the Vedantin means is that in the Maya, at that time, the reflection of consciousness takes place. Mama yonir mahat brahma tasmin garbham dadhamyaham. Lord Krishna says that I inject the garbha in my yoni, which is Maya, meaning that I get reflected in Maya. And that's how the Maya that was so far unconscious now starts becoming conscious. So that is how the creation begins. As long as Maya is inactive, unconscious, so long there is no movement, there is no creation. When Ishvara imparts his reflection to Maya, then Maya becomes as though conscious and it starts unfolding in the form of creation. That is all right. But how can you call Brahman the Karta? How can you say Brahman is a seer? The modifications may take place in the Maya, all right. But when you say he saw, Brahman saw, it saw, then seeing also is a modification. But that cannot take place in consciousness that is changeless. So Brahman is changeless consciousness. So how can the modification of seeing also take place in Brahman? Mayopadika bimba chinmatrasya ishvarasya. Ishvara or Brahman chinmatrasya, that is merely of the nature of consciousness, which is called bimba, the image that's reflected in Maya. So in reflect Maya, the changes are there. So karma is there. But there is no activity on the part of Brahman. So some activity takes place also on the part of the seer. Not only should there be object of seeing, but when I see something, some activity which is conducive to seeing takes place in my mind also, then only I can be called seer. But Brahman is changeless consciousness, therefore how can any activity take place in Brahman? So, bimba matrasya ishvarasya katham ikshanam prati mukhyam kartrutvam. Mahasekara said that when there is an object of seeing, then you can call the seer, Brahman, as seer in the primary sense. So, objects are there in the undifferentiated, unmanifested. They are there. But nothing happens to Brahman. How can you call Brahman the seer? Kruti abhavati chet, because there is no kruti, there is no karma, there is no modification in consciousness. How can we call consciousness seer in primary sense? In secondary sense, you can say like the sun illumines, but here in the primary sense, even the object of seeing is there. If there is no modification in consciousness, how can you call consciousness a seer in the primary sense? Iti chet, if that's your objection, na karyanukula jnanavadeva kartrutvata. So who is a jnana karta? Who is a pramata? Who is a knower? Karyanukula jnanavata. One who possesses the knowledge that is conducive to what is to be created. So here kartrutvata. In fact, as far as the seer is concerned, there is no independence. The seer does not have freedom really. As we said, vastu tantram jnanam, the knowledge is always determined by the object of knowledge, and there is therefore no modification, no change in the seer. So you do not require a change in consciousness to call consciousness a doer. All that you require is karyanukula jnanavatah, the one that possesses jnanam, knowledge, which is karyanukulam, which is conducive to what is to be karyam, what is to be created. Really speaking, there is a footnote here which you don't have. Karyanukula kruti matahaiva kartrutvam. Really speaking, who is a karta? One who acts, one in whom there is some change conducive to what is to be done. Karta is the one who is conducive to what is to be created, what is to be done. So karyanukula kruti matah, a karta is the one who performs an act which is conducive to what is to be done. Jnana dehe kruti asadhyatvena. So karma, kartrutvam can be there because karma is purushatantram. Therefore, karta can be said to be karta because he is free to do things or not do things. Then a person can be called karta or doer in primary sense. But in jnanam, in knowledge, that kind of doership is not there. So karyatvam nasyat. Therefore, jnatrutvam cannot be called really any, because no karma is involved in the part of jnata. Atmanascha ashrautam krutimattvam kalpayitavyam. Shruti does not say that krutimattvam, there is any karma on the part of atma. Therefore, the Tikakara has very intelligently defined kartrutvam is what? Karyanukula jnanavada, not karyanukula krutimada. Kayanukula jnanavatayav kartrutvam kartrutvat. Even kruti also comes after jnanam. So, when a pot maker does something, then it's called karta. But before that doing, the knowledge of what is to be done is there. So, we say that the one who knows what is to be done is a karta. Not what it does, what is to be done. But one knows what is to be done, also can be called karta. Ishvarasyapi ikshana anukula nitya jnanavatvat. So Ishvara also is consciousness, nitya jnanam, which is conducive to ikshanam, conducive to what is seeing. Nacha nitya jnanenaiva kartrutva nirvahakatvat kim ikshanameti vachyam. So here Vedantin says that nitya jnanavatvam, being changed in his consciousness, is itself is ikshanam, because in that consciousness is contained the knowledge conducive to ikshanam, seeing. So he says that if Brahman can be called jnana kartru, Brahman can be called the seer by virtue of his being consciousness, then why do you say he saw? It is just consciousness. Why didn't you say that? Kim ikshana yadi vachyam. Why should Shruti say tad aikshata? When really no real seeing is involved in the part of Brahman. Itina vachyam. That argument should not be made. Now, these people now, you know, when one argument is made, then you change your position in a different way. So says, vayavadeheva sabdavatva sambhavat kim akashanedi ati prasanga. This question can be asked in many other cases. If by virtue of consciousness Brahman can be called a seer, then why do you say Brahman saw? Why do you call him seer? Because Shruti says. Answer is because that's what Shruti says. For example, you can ask the question that this guna called shabda, sound. Now, Prithvi, The earth has a quality called fragrance or the smell. Water has a quality of taste, because that can be all perceived. Fire has a quality of color, perceived. Vayu has a quality of sparsha, the touch. But when it comes to shabda, you say Akash has the quality of sound. Now how did you arrive at that? Why didn't you say that the vayu itself is a quality of sound? Why do? Because you can hear vayu. When the wind blows, you can, it creates a sound, you can hear. Akash you cannot hear. So why didn't you say the sound is a quality of vayu? So don't tell us that. Shruti says that. This kind of question can be asked in many other cases also. Therefore, Akashen Ati Prasangat. So Kim Angikara what is it? Sabdavatu Samvat Kim Akashen Ati Prasangat. He says, well, these questions will arise in many cases. Because when we cannot determine something, like sound of space is not perceived like other elements are perceived. Therefore, that space as the quality of sound is by inference as far as we are concerned. But really, we say that space as sound because Shruti says that Atah Shrutatvat Vayavadi Karanatvena Akashavat. Vayu is created from what? It is created from Akasha. How do you say that? Because Shruti says that Akashad Vayu. That's all. So we do not have the perception or inference or logic to arrive at the cause of Vayu. We can't see where from Vayu is created. We have to only accept what the Shruti says. So Vayu does possess the sound. But vayu also is created. Therefore, the cause of vayu should primarily possess sound. That is why Akasha has the quality of sound. That's all. Tadvat aikshatedi agantukam tvena sutam ikshanam. Similarly, tad aikshata agantukatvena. Not that it always sees. It sees at the time of creation. Akashadi hetutvena angikaryam. So just as we accept Akasha as the cause of vayu on the strength of what the Shruti says, so also we accept that ikshanam as the cause of vayu. From that ikshanam, cause of Akasha. From that ikshanam alone, the whole universe beginning from Akasha got created. Tasmadva etasmad atmanah akasha sambhutah. That's all. Iti alam. So then, when it comes to questioning what cannot be determined by the available means of knowledge, then we always resort to Shruti. There we do not arrive at the conclusion by reasoning. There we arrive at conclusion by the Shruti. Then as far as the Seshwaravadinam Pradyaha, those who accept Ishvara like the Patpatanjalas, who accept Ishvara as the witnessing consciousness, then there is no problem. Yat Prasadadhi Yogyanapi Atita Anagata Vishayam Pratyaksham Jnana Vichandi Yoga Shastra Vidaha. Those who are adept in the scriptures of Yoga Shastra, they say that the yogis also have their siddhis or omniscience because of the grace of Ishvara. So whatever knowledge the yogis have is because of the grace of Ishvara. So if by Ishvara's grace yogis also can know what is there in all the three periods of time, if a yogi can know, a yogi can be sarvajna, then what log of Ishvara by whose grace yogi becomes sarvajna? That Ishvara is sarvajna, that is, how can, that's kaimuti kanya, what you talk of Ishvara being sarvajna.
Now continuing,
yadapi says jnayindinana jivascheva ishvarasyapi jnana anuguna hetu apeksham anuvadati.
Then Sankhya had said earlier in his argument
that apicha pragutpatte sarvakaraka sunyam brahma ishade tvaya. Earlier the Sankhya had made an argument, hey Vedantin, you say that before creation Brahman does not have body or the mind or sense organs, karyakarana is not there.
Nacha jnana sadhananam sarirendriyanam bhave jnanotpatti kasyachit upapanna.
We do not find that anybody can know anything without the body and the mind and sense organs. So you require to know the objects of the world, you require body, sense organs, mind, then only knowledge can take place. But before creation, there is no body, no sense organs, no mind, jnana karana. So the means of knowledge are not yet created. Then how can you say that Brahman knew everything, Brahman saw everything? This was the argument that is now being taken up here by Bhashyakara.
Yadapi uktam pragutpatteh brahmanah shariradi sambandham antarena ikshitritvam anupapannam iti natata chodnyam avatarade savitru prakashavada brahmanah jnanaswarupa nityatve jnana sadhana apeksha anupapattehe.
Yadavi uktam, so the Purupakshidas, Sankhedas, did you know what you said earlier?
Pragutpattehe brahmanah shariradi sambandham antarena.
Before the creation, there is no body. Brahman doesn't have body, doesn't have sense organs, doesn't have mind, doesn't have the conventional means of knowledge.
Ikshitritvam anupannamiti.
How can Brahman be called knower? How can Brahman know when the very means of knowledge are not yet created? How can you be called a householder when a house is not created? How can be called father when this child is not born? So also, how can Brahman be called knower when the means of knowledge are not there before creation?
Iti, you know, remember you have said this, you know.
So, natat chodyam avatarati. That chodyam or question has no room at all. Now that does not arise. In light of what we already discussed, that question has no place at all. Why?
Savitru prakashvad brahmanah jnana rupa nityatve jnana sadhana apeksha anupattehe.
Savitru prakashvad, like the light of the sun, that is constant.
Brahmanah jnana rupa nityatve,
so also Brahman is the changeless consciousness.
Jnana sadhana,
so just as the sun does not require any body or sense organs or mind to be called an illuminator. Sun illumines or sun shines. For shining or illumining, just as the sun does not require a body or sense or mind, because to illumine or shine is the nature of sun. For nature, you do not require any other additional help. For the fire to be hot, fire doesn't require anything other than itself. For sun to be bright, sun does not require anything other than itself. So also, for Brahman to be conscious, to shine, does not require anything other than itself. Brahman doesn't require a mind to shine, doesn't require sense organs to shine, doesn't require a body to shine. And by virtue of shining alone, we say that Brahman saw. So that objection is already answered. Jnana sadhana apeksha anupatte hai. There is no logical requirement for the expectation of jnana sadhanam, the means of knowledge, such as sense organs, mind, etc. So say Nyanyana Vastutaha Nityasya Svataha Hetu Anapekshatvat. We say it Vastutaha Nityasya Svataha Hetu Anapekshatvat. So that which is a nature does not require any hetu. So fire does not require anything other than itself to burn. Sun does not require other than anything other than itself to shine. So also Brahman does not require anything other than itself to be conscious. So na tat chodyam avatarati tadeva vyatirekena sadhayati apichayati. Or says Ratna Prabha, avyakrita karyoparakta chaitanya swarupena swarupa ikshanasya karaka anapekshatvepi vritti rupa ikshanasya karakam vachyam. So Purupakshi says, all right, Brahman is of the nature of consciousness. So it is true that Brahman does not require our body or sense organs to be conscious, to shine. But Brahman also will require a mind to see something. So avyakrita karyoparakta chaitanya rupa ikshanasya karaka anapekshatvepi. So Brahman eliminates all the undifferentiated name and form. In that sense, Brahman does not to eliminate the undifferentiated name and form. Before creation, Brahman does not require a mind or sense organs. But to see those things, now you gave the example of pot maker. So in mind of pot maker, actually, a vritti or a thought takes place. So then he sees with his mind or sees with his sense organs. So vritti rupa ikshanasya karakam vachyam. Ikshanam, or seeing in the form of vritti. In the pot maker, a vritti takes place of seeing. In Ishvara also, for that vritti to take place, karakam vachyam, you require some karakam, some means. Iti asankya, having raised a doubt, the answer is given. Abhichaityadana Bhashyakara says, अपिच अविद्यादिमतः संसारिणः शरीरादि अपेक्षा ज्ञानोत्पत्ति स्यात् न ज्ञान प्रतिबंध कारण रहितस्य ईश्वरस्य. अपिच फर्दर avidyadimatah samsarinah. All these requirements of the sense organs, the body, the mind that you are talking about, that to see something or to know something, you require sense organs, you require mind. All of these requirements are there in case of an ignorant individual, in case of a jiva. So avidyadimatah samsarinah, a samsari, a transmigrating soul or a jiva, avidyamata, who is ignorant, shariradi apeksha jnanotpatti syad. Shariradi apeksha is the visheshan of jnanotpatti. Shariradi apeksha yasyaha saha shariradi apeksha. That's how it is. So jnanotpatti. Jnanotpatti meaning what? The creation of knowledge requires a body, sense organs, etc. in case of a jiva who is ignorant. Na jnana pratibandha kana hetasya ishvaras. Because even though jiva also is consciousness, But jiva is not seeing all the time because the knowledge of a jiva is obstructed by ignorance, by likes, avidya, kama, karma. They are the obstructions to the manifestation of knowledge of jiva. That's what Lord Krishna said to Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita, Bahuni me vyatitani janmani tava charjuna tanyaham veda sarvani natvam vetha parantapa. Hey parantapa, in as much as I am consciousness, you are also consciousness, in that sense we are same. And still, I know all that happened in the past, all the births that I took and you took and everybody took, I know all of them. Natvam vehe parandapa, but you do not know them because your knowledge is obstructed by avidya, kama, karma, dharma, adharma. All of these obstruct the knowledge. Whereas in my case, there is no obstruction of knowledge. Therefore, knowledge is spontaneous. So the Ishvara is devoid of any obstacles to knowledge. Therefore, he does not require to remove those obstacles. So understand that the sense organs and mind are required for an ordinary person to remove the obstacles to knowledge. Just as the Dakshinamurti Stotra says that how a jar which is in a dark room, in that jar there is a lamp, a powerful lamp, but the jar obstructs the illumination of the part of the lamp, and the rays of light from the jar emanate from the apertures that we make, and that's the restriction of knowledge. That lamp in the jar, had the jar not been there, the lamp would have illuminated the entire room simultaneously. But because the jar which obstructs the illumination is there, therefore the lamp cannot illumine the room. So the consciousness shining in my heart would illuminate everything simultaneously. But then the ignorance is there, the body is there, all these are the obstructions to knowledge. Therefore, knowledge requires the apertures. Just as that lamp requires apertures or holes in the jar for the light to emanate, here also the sense organs are required. And that lamp can only illumine what falls on the path of those beams of light. So also the self can only illumine those objects which fall on the path of the beams emerging from the sense organs. So in case of jiva, the sense organs of mind are required to remove the obstacle to knowledge. In case of Ishvara, there is no obstacle to knowledge. Therefore, he does not require the sense organs in mind. Therefore, says Ratnava, yatha ekasya jnanam tatha anyasyapeti niyama bhavat. What the rules or the restrictions that apply to jiva should also apply to Ishvara. There is no rule. What applies to one should necessarily apply to another one. That rule is not there. Mayinah asharirasyapi janya ikshana karakatvam iti bhavah. Mayinah, therefore, Ishvara, who possesses maya as a shakti. Asharirasyapi, because Ishvara possesses maya, which is what? Vishuddha sattva gunatmika. Maya is Vishuddha sattva. Therefore, you do not, there is no obstruction to knowledge. If rajas and tamas are there, they obstruct the knowledge of a jiva. But Ishvara's mind, which is maya, is pure sattva. Therefore, no obstacles of rajas tamas are there. So you don't require anything to remove those obstacles. So, mayinah ishvarasyapi janya ikshana. The ikshana that is yet to be born. Karaka ikshana niyamam asharisapi janya ikshana karakatvam iti bhavah. Meaning that maya itself is enough for the ikshanam that is to take place. And over and above maya, Ishvara does not require
any sense organs or body, etc.
Sri Ratna Brahma, Nanu yad janya jnanam tat sharira sadhyam iti vyapti hi asti. But this general rule is there. Yad janya jnanam tat sharira sadhyam. So whatever knowledge is born, that knowledge gets born or takes place only when there is a body. Otherwise, because the jiva requires his body to communicate with the world. Sukshma sharira is actually the means of knowledge. But sukshma sharira itself is not enough. Sukshma sharira requires also the abode in the form of a gross body. Then alone sukshma sharira can interact with the world. So nanu yat janya jnanam, then only the perception or cognition of the objects the world can take place. Yat janya jnanam tat sharira sadhyam iti, that is necessarily achieved and accomplished with the help of body. Iti vyapti asti, that vyapti is there. Iti ashankya. So how can you say that rule does not apply? You say that the rule that applies to jiva, you can't insist that it applies to Ishvara. But here we are talking about a general rule. We observe that there is body is required for the cognition to take place. Therefore, why should that rule not apply to Ishvara? So when we say general rule, so wherever the smoke is, there the fire is. You can't say that in America that rule does not apply. So what applies to India also applies to America. Similarly, wherever the cognition takes place, then the body is seen to be there. So why should that rule not apply to Ishvara? Iti asankya shruti badama. So shruti says, so understand that all the arguments here are based on shruti. Later on, all of these will be established with yukti also. Right now, only shruti is taken as a basis for refuting the position of Sankhya. Mantravacha Subhashyaka says, Mantravacha imau Ishvarasya Shariradi Anapekshatam Anavarana Jnanatam Cha Darshayataha. Mantravacha imau, these two mantras that come from the Vedas, from the Upanishad, Shvetashvatara Upanishad in this case. Ishvarasya, thank God that these Vedantins get something somewhere, you know. There may not be too many mantras, but somewhere is there, that's enough. Vedanta says, what Shruti says here. So you can say Shruti says everywhere. But Shruti is one body of knowledge. What is said in one place also applies everywhere. So mantra uchayamo Ishvarasya, these two mantras, Ishvarasya shariradi anapekshatam, that Ishvara does not require shariradi, body, sense organs, mind, etc. Anavarana jnanatam, because Ishvara's knowledge is anavaranam, it is devoid of any veiling, it is always a manifest knowledge. There is no obstacle to the manifestation of knowledge of Ishvara. Both this, that Ishvara's knowledge is unobstructed, and two, Ishvara does not require the body, etc. Both these things are stated in these two mantras. Says mantra, Natasya karyam karanam cha vidyate natat samascha abhyadikascha drushyate parasya shaktir vividhai vashruyate svabhaviki jnana balakriyacha ite apanipado javano grahita pashyatya chakshusya shrunotya karanah Saveti Vedyam Nachatasya Stivetta
तमाहुरग्र्यं पुरुषं महान्तम् इति च न तस्य कार्यं करणं च विद्यते। श्री रत्नवर कार्यं शरीरं करणं इंद्रियं न तस्य कार्यं करणं च विद्यते। ऑफ द ईश्वरा देयर इज नो कार्यं नो बॉडी नो सेंस ऑर्गन्स न तत् समस्य अभ्यधिकस्य दृश्यते। देयर इज नो वन हु इज इक्वल टू ईश्वरा वेयर द क्वेश्चन ऑफ समवन हु इज इवन सुपीरियर टू हिम दैट क्वेश्चन डज नॉट अराइज। परास्य शक्तिः विविधैव श्रूयते परा अस्य शक्तिः विविधा एव श्रूयते। अस्य ईश्वरस्य श्री रत्नर्व शक्तिः माया दैट मंत्र इज एक्सप्लेन्ड। अस्य ईश्वरस्य शक्तिः माया इसको परा माया इसको परा शक्तिः माया इसको परा स्वकार्य अपेक्षया परा। सो माया इज द शक्ति और द पावर ऑफ ईश्वर इट इज द सुप्रीम पावर। सो इट इज द सुपीरियर पावर कंपेयर टू द क्रिएशन यूनिवर्स दैट इज टू बी क्रिएटेड। सो दिस सुपीरियर पावर ऑफ ईश्वर इज विविधा शक्ति इज अ डाइवर्स विचित्र कार्य कार्यत्वाद विविधा। सो इवन दो माया इज कॉल्ड वन विद इन माया देयर इज पोटेंशियल ऑफ वैरायटी ऑफ क्रिएशन। माया इज विविधा शक्ति इट इज अ डाइवर्स पावर ऑफ द लॉर्ड बिकॉज इन माया देयर इज पोटेंशियल ऑफ द डाइवर्स क्रिएशन। सो विचित्र कार्य कार्य विचित्र मीन्स वॉट वेरीगेटेड diverse vichitra karya karyatvat because maya is the creator of this diverse creation therefore ishvara shakti is said to be superior and diverse swabhaviki gnana bala kriya cha that maya is swabhaviki means what anadi uncreated spontaneous gnana bala kriya cha so gnanam knowledge bala is power kriya is action that is explained okay vividaiva shruyate shruyate se ratnavrava satu aitihya matra siddha na pramana siddha who says that ishvara has such a power aitihya matra siddha aitihya means legendary this you know account itihas what is aitihya where nobody knows who said it or that is either you do not know who made that statement who said it or there is nobody who said it just coming down itihasa is so even sage valmiki wrote ramayana but he wrote based on the legends that were available at that time so you cannot blame valmiki for everything that is in ramayana because he just wrote what he heard He did not create Ramayana. It's called Itihasa. Mahabharata is called Itihasa. Vedavyasa did not create the story. He just wrote the account of what was legendary there. So, kim vadanti, whatever they say, you know. And so, Aitihya. So, the Pauranikas accept Aitihya also as a Pramanam. Vedanti, they don't accept, we don't accept, but Pauranikas. Because Purana is based on that. Purana tells us so many stories, nobody knows where the story came from and who told the story. It's all legendary. So did this happen in Dhruva, in Swami Prahlada, all this happened? Sometimes they ask this question. Was there Hiranyakashipu like that? Was there a Ravana? Did Kumbhakarna exist? Did Meghana, did he do all these things? Aitihyam. So they say. Shruti doesn't say that. If Shruti says that, then of course the Shruti is a Pramana. So you don't find this thing in Vedas on one hand. You don't find any other proof. So it is here that what is coming down to us, Paramparaya, you know, by succession of the speakers, so Kathakaras, they keep on repeating the story. So it has become like a real thing. That's why the question, was there a Rama? Was there Ramayana or did it actually? That's the question here.
How do you say there was Rama? Itihasa. There is no evidence anywhere, no proof. So in the court all these things happened, you know. Because the question, Rama Mandir, how do you say there was a Rama Mandir? First prove that there was Rama, then there is a question of Rama Mandir. So, Aitihyam, because people accept it. So it is there. That Aitihyam also is a Pramana. Anyway, but so you say that Ishvara has this Maya Sakti. Is there a proof? Or is this just coming? It says, Shruyate, Pramana Siddha. Shruti says that. It is not simply legend, but Shruyate, Shruti says that. Swabhaviki Jnana Bala Kriya. So says here, Jnana Rupa. Jnana Bala is what? Jnana Rupam Balam. The Balam, the power of the nature of knowledge. So Ishvara possesses power. Knowledge itself is power. You do not require any other kind of power. So Jnana Bala Kriya. Jnana Rupena Balena Ya Srishti Kriya Sa Swabhaviki. The Kriya or the act of creation on the part of Ishvara is spontaneous. Ishvara does not have to make any effort to create. Swabhaviki, spontaneous. What kind of power is there? For Kriya, you require always power. For performing any action, you require balam, you require strength, you require vigor. What kind of balam? Ishvara's Jnana Kriya, Jnana Balam. So, Ishvara's balam or this power is of the nature of knowledge. And by the on account of the power of knowledge or the vigor of knowledge, the creation spontaneously takes place. No effort is involved on the part of Ishvara to create. See, by studying this Brahma Sutra, you are learning also what Vedanta Siddhanta is, you know. Everything connected to Srushti or Sarjanam is all discussed here. And so, how does Vedanta see all this creation? The Swabhavigi. So, Swabhavigi is what? It is natural, uncreated, effortless, spontaneous. Why is Swabhavigi? Anadi mayatmakatvad ityartha. Even that Kriya. Normally an action is commenced. Usually you begin an action. Action is not always there. But this action, Srishti Kriya, is Swabhaviki. It is uncreated because it is a result of ignorance, which is anadi, anadi mayatmakatvat. Because maya is anadi, therefore the Kriya, which is maya as its nature, also is anadi, Swabhaviki. Or says Ratna Baba, so Swabhaviki Jnana Bala Kriya, that expression is explained in a different way also. Jnanasya Chaitanyasya Balam. What is Jnanam is Chaitanyam. First the Jnana was accepted as omniscience. Here Jnana is accepted as consciousness. So omniscience, of course, that power of knowledge is there. But consciousness, what power is there? So, jnanasya chaitanyasya balam maya vritti pratibimbitatvena sphutatvam. The power that consciousness has is being reflected in maya. That's all. So, real power is all in maya. But that maya is powerless unless Brahman, in fact, enlivens it. So, actually, power is in maya. But if maya had power, then Maya should be able to independently create things, which Maya does not. Maya can create only when there is the reflection of consciousness. So we have to say that consciousness has power. Is it not so? If Maya's own power was there, it should create. It cannot. Only in presence of consciousness, reflected, not only in presence of consciousness. So we say that consciousness gets reflected. That is called Ishvarecha. So Vaisheshika say that by the desire of Ishvara, Sankalpa of Ishvara, Sushti takes place. But sankalpa also is a modification which the Vedantins do not accept. Therefore, they say that reflection of consciousness in Maya. In reflection, no effort is required. So, in the beginning of creation, consciousness gets reflected in Maya. That's how Maya becomes enlivened. So, the balam, jnanasya, chaitanyasya balam, Maya vritti, pratibimbitatvena, sphutatvam. So, in Maya, there is modification. In that modification, consciousness gets reflected. That is called jnana balam. That's the power of consciousness. Tasya kriya nama. How does that bimba? How does that consciousness perform kriya? Tasya kriya nama. Bimbatvena brahmana janakata jnatrutapi. So primarily knowingness and doingness is in Maya. But because Maya's knowingness and doingness cannot be effective unless the reflection of consciousness is there, so you can say that reflection, and therefore the one who gets reflected, that bimba alone, has the jnana, jnatrutvam and kartrutvam. You can secondarily assign. Brahman is called jagat karanam, not in a primary sense, only in a secondary sense, through Maya. So Brahman can be called the knower and doer through the agency of Maya, not in the primary sense. Then said, apani pado javano grahita pasyati achakshuhu sa shrunoti akarana. Apani padaha, apani, without the hands, apadaha, without the legs, javanaha, grahita. So without the legs, javanaha, he is very quick, he is very fast. And grahita, without the hands or arms, he grasps. So grasping is the action of hands and moving is the action of legs. He doesn't have legs, he doesn't have arms, and still he moves fast and he grasps everything. Meaning that Ishvara does not require legs to move, does not require arms to grasp. Pashyati achakshuhu, he sees without the eyes. Shrunoti akaranah, he hears without the ears. Meaning to see, he doesn't require eyes. To hear, does not require ears. So he says, apani hi grahita, because apani pado javano grahita. The yatha sankhyam is not there. Pani pada and javano grahita. So clarification, apani hi api grahita, apado api javanah. Even though he doesn't have hands or arms, still he grasps. Even though he doesn't have legs, still he is swift. Javanah. Ishvarasya svakarye laukika hetu apeksha nasti iti bhavah. Meaning that the ignorant person may require hands to grasp and legs to move, but that rule cannot be applied to Ishvara because Shruti says that. So Ishvarasya svakarye, for Ishvara to accomplish his action. Laukika hetu apeksha nasti, the hetu of the causes required in your day-to-day life, that expectation or requirement is not there. Tamahuragriyam purusham mahantam na vesavetti vedyam na cha tasyasti vetta. Savetti vedyam, he knows everything that is to be known. Kim bahuna sarvapi vedana yogyam. Vedyam means what? Vedana yogyam, that which is to be known or which can be known. Karyakarana apeksha. Kaya anapeksho vetti. So without karyakarana, without body and sense organs, savetti vedyam, whatever is to be known, he knows. Natasyasti vetta, there is no knower of him. Says, parivasitam tasmin veditritvam atah natasyanya veditasti. Says Upanishad, there is no knower other than him, then he is only knower. That's how he is called knower. Because there is no knower other than him, therefore he can be called knower. That's how. Parivasitam tasmin vetritvam. ultimately vetrutvam, the knowership, ultimately rests in only Brahman, because there is no knower other than him. Still knowing takes place. So knowing takes place and there is no knower other than Brahman. Therefore, Brahman is a knower. Nitya Svarnatvacha, also because it is always shining as consciousness. Therefore, it is knower, or because there is no knower other than Brahman. Therefore, also it is knower. So, Nata Savetti Vedyam, Nacha Tasyasti Veta, Tamahuragriyam, Purusham Mahantam, Tamcha Adhikartaram, Mahantam Achakshate, Brahma Vidaha. The knowers of Brahma call that Adipurusha Mahantam. Mahantam is Vibhum, all powerful, all pervasive. Agriyam, Anadim, beginningless, first one. Agriyam is the one, the very primary one. Purusha means Anantam, Tamahur Agriyam, Purusha Mahantam. And so, Brahma Vida, Ahuhu, the knowers of Brahma call that Paramatma Agriyam, the first one. Purusham, here all pervasive. Anantam, Mahantam, Vibhum, all powerful. This is what the knowers of Brahman call him. So to accept it, because you know nothing else to refute this. The thing is that we say that you cannot apply to Ishvara the rules that are applicable to Jiva. How do you apply them? What kind of reason do you have to apply the same rules? So you don't have any proof. We have the proof where Shruti says that those rules are not applicable. So we have Shruti in our favor. You don't have that. In that sense, by the on the strength of the Shruti, that position is refuted. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. प्रसाद से भी आज बदाम आटा प्रसाद लेने जा रहा हूँ।